This video was made possible through the support of my patrons. This video is also sponsored by Zavi. Hello ladies and gentlemen, my name is Mr. TARDIS, and welcome today to my unboxing of the Evil of the Daleks animated recreation Steelbook. Normally I just get the standard Blu-ray editions of these, but we'll talk about this in a minute, but I wasn't really a big fan of the cover until I saw people getting their own hands on it. But when this was announced, I just saw the Steelbook cover and thought, I've just got to absolutely have this. And if you know anything about my channel, if you know anything about these unboxing videos, you'll know that I'm a big fan of Steelbooks anyway, so it's not exactly a big deal for me. Now, this was released like a week ago, and I'm unboxing this as soon as I received it. There have, of course, if you're living outside the UK, you may be aware, there have been some delivery issues, some transport issues, some postal issues, because of everything that's happening, mostly due to breakfast, so we won't really talk about that on this channel. So let's open up this and look at the beautiful Steelbook inside. Now this is a beautiful, gorgeous cover. This is, yeah, I am incredibly happy that I was able to get a hold of the Steelbook. It will look out of place in my standard Blu-ray collection of these animated recreations, but, you know, I just think this is an absolutely wonderful piece of work. I will, I think, maybe just get the standard edition Blu-ray at some point, maybe when there is a price drop, but this just does look incredible. I love the look of this, the Emperor Dalek there, the Daleks here surrounding the TARDIS, and on the back as well. We do have the card, but it is more or less this image of the Second Doctor and Jamie looking on in horror at what is transpiring on Skaro. So because of this reflective light on the ceiling, we're going to get rid of the plastic cover, and then we'll take a look at the special features and what is included in this Steelbook. So yeah, you've got the wonderful, like, matte feeling. It's shiny, it's beautiful. The Emperor Dalek looks incredible on this cover. If we take the cardboard sleeve off, which I do keep, I will be keeping this cardboard sleeve, but we'll lose it for now. Yeah, so we've got the shiny TARDIS at the bottom here, and we have the Doctor and Jamie on the back. Yeah, this just looks beautiful. I do love how the Steelbook Rangers have been quite consistent stylistically. Just move that sleeve out. What we have is that we have on the right side, on the front cover, we have the TARDIS in some sort of precarious situation, and on the left here, we've got the Doctor just reacting to what is going on here. I think it's a great aesthetic for the Steelbooks. It looks consistent. We've also got the upcoming Galaxy 4 Steelbook, which I've also pre-ordered, which hits the exact same notes. It's just a brilliant and really inventive way to give the Steelbooks a sort of sense of harmony, gives a sort of sense of consistency. I love it. I love it a lot. So let's use this cardboard sleeve and use this booklet to break down what is exactly going to be in this set. So for those of you who may not know, Evil of the Daleks is a Second Doctor story that was released in 1967. It's a 7-part story written by David Whittaker, who wrote Power of the Daleks, and also directed by Doctor Who veteran director Derek Martinez. So this is a 7-part story, and on this Blu-ray box set, the 7-part story is completely recreated in both colour and also in black and white. And we also have the original episode 2. So episodes 1, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 are missing, lost of the archives, no idea where they are, presumably junked, presumably destroyed. So we have this animated recreation. Along with the recreation, we also have the special features, audio commentaries, the Evil of the Daleks audiobook narrated by Tom Baker. This is a release, I believe, from the 1990s. We've got a photo gallery, we've got an animation gallery, just a quick look behind the scenes. There's no actual behind the scenes on the animation process for the Evil of the Daleks. We've also got episode reconstructions with optional commentary from Fraser Hines. These are elaborate telesnap recreations if for whatever reason you did not want to watch the animated version. We've got The Last Dalek, which is surviving film footage of the miniatures for the final battle in episode 7 with the Daleks and the Dalek Emperor. That is a feature that I believe was on the Tomb of the Cybermen DVD, or was it the Lost in Time DVD? It's a previous release. That Last Dalek feature is something we have seen before, but it's great to see it here. An assignment with Grim Evil, interview with Chris Thompson. Is that Chris Thompson as in Patrick Troughton impressionist Chris Thompson? If so, awesome. The Dalek Factor, which is a making-of documentary. Episode 1 with 1968 introduction audio. I'm not sure what that is, but we'll dive into that and find out. And also PDF ROM content, where you get stuff like camera scripts and also just original documentation from around the time of the story's broadcast. And you've got this booklet as well, which does have the artwork, which is on the standard DVD and Blu-ray release. Now, this is the artwork which convinced me to get the Steelbook, because I thought, this doesn't really look that interesting. There's a hell of a lot of dead space on the top right. Patrick Troughton is just pulling a bit of a blank expression here, and I thought, you know what, I might as well just get the Steelbook, because that just does look gorgeous. However, when I saw the DVD and Blu-ray had the reversible sleeve, the empty space on the top right made a lot more sense, because it's taken up by the Doctor Who logo and the episode title. I'll put an image on the screen now. It just looks really, really good. So, you know what? I maybe might have been a bit too quick to judge. I may have been a bit too hasty. No regrets, the Steelbook looks gorgeous, but maybe I shouldn't have dismissed the artwork at first sight. Jamie and Victoria still look a little bit strange down here on the bottom right. They look quite tiny. Anyway, in this booklet, we've got production notes, we've got some images from The Evil of the Daleks, some behind-the-scenes information here, quite a few pages of it. I'll have to make my way through this at some point. We've got a quick list here of who has been involved in this animated recreation. Cover artist Giada Strinati, so that is the person who we have to thank for this wonderful artwork. Okay, it turns out that Chris Thompson, the impressionist of Patrick Troughton, is not the Chris Thompson they're talking about here. No, he's the production designer on the original 1967 production of The Evil of the Daleks, here to discuss his work on the serial in an unreleased interview from 2018. That is one hell of a coincidence. That would have actually been a pretty cool special feature, getting Chris Thompson to talk about Patrick Troughton. And on the back, we've just got a little breakdown of the production team who were involved, as well as original transmission date and how many people viewed the story overall. Now, before we take a look at the inside of the case, I just wanted to give a quick shout out to this video's sponsor, Zavvi. I did pre-order this item from Zavvi, and at time of recording, they do still have some Steelbooks available. And because the item has been released now, if you use the coupon code MrTardis10 at checkout, you can get 10% off anything in store. And if you use the coupon code MrTardis20, you can get 20% off any clothing in the store as well. As a massive fan of Steelbooks, Zavvi is one of my favourite online stores to go to, and I thank them hugely for supporting my channel. Some of the more recent Steelbooks I've gotten since I have done a unboxing video was Nightcrawler with Jake Gyllenhaal. That's a brilliant looking Steelbook there. We also have the Lego Movie, the second part, and these two I think are really, really cool. Two of my favourite X-Men movies, X-Men First Class and Logan. You've got these lenticular covers as well, and if they are not your bag, that's fair enough, because these are actually, I didn't know this until I bought them, these are magnets. You can take these off and stick them anywhere, and you've just got the cover there as well. Most of the X-Men films, I believe, still have Steelbooks available, but I had to get these ones because these are my favourite X-Men movies. I've also pre-ordered a special anniversary edition of Terminator 2 Judgment Day. It's one of my favourite films, so when that was announced on the website, I just had to immediately pre-order it. If Steelbooks or any pop culture geeky stuff is your bag, I presume it is because you are watching this channel, then please consider shopping at Zavvi using an affiliate link in the description below, and also use the coupon code MrTardis10 or MrTardis20 to get 10 or 20% off respectively on the website. Now with that out of the way, let's open this thing up. So this is a 3-disc set. All of the discs appear to have the exact same artwork. That's the cover artwork. That's not a big deal, that's absolutely fine. But if we take these away, we get a shot that is inside the Waterfield Mansion of the Doctor playing trains with the Daleks. If you've not seen the story, if you don't know anything about it, that must seem quite strange out of context, but I swear it makes sense and it's one of the best parts of the story. So what we'll do is that we'll just do a quick breakdown of what you get on the Blu-ray set, and then we'll come right back to the conclusion of this box set.
To select audio navigation, press enter now.
So on these Blu-ray sets, you've got 3 discs to work with 3 different ways to watch The Evil of the Daleks, with each DVD menu showing a render of the back room in Waterfield's antique shop. On disc 1, you've got the animated recreation from BBC Studios in the 4:3 aspect ratio, and in black and white with a slight filter grain. For special features, you've got audio commentaries, but more on that later. Disc 2 has the same recreation, but in full screen and colour, as well as the audio commentaries, and disc 3 has a telesnap recreation, which includes animated scenes with the Daleks and the Emperor. Probably not the ideal way to view it, but I am glad it's an option here. Now let's briefly talk about the animation before we move on to the special features. Now the ideal way to watch this release is the colour full screen version. It's really well done. Now looking at the scenes side by side, using the surviving episode 2 as a reference, it's a really faithful recreation, but there's still the issue of the limited time and resources, making it difficult to fully capture Patrick Troughton's incredible performance and facial expressions. But still, the Daleks look great, the Emperor is an incredible and intimidating 3D model, and the final end is the visual highlight. It's a great action set piece. But across the serial as well, there are some really inventive and ambitious setups and shots to be found here. Slight nitpick though is that the animated version does change the final shot, where it's a lone surviving Dalek at the end instead of the Emperor with a light pulsating inside. It seems like a really strange choice, especially since that pulsating light's inclusion is a now famous anecdote about how showrunner at the time Innes Lloyd rang the studio floor on the shoot day begging the team to not kill off the Daleks permanently. So the team on set found a single light bulb in storage and incorporated that into the episode. I also wish they'd frazzled Patrick Troughton's hair more when he escaped Skaro, but these are the pickiest of nits. Also, the 4x3 version is good, but the framing has definitely been composed with the full screen version in mind. Sometimes characters are just outright missing from shots because of the framing, and look at this, Patrick Troughton here is dipping in and out of view. Also, and because I was the only person in the world who was curious, this release does not have paperback writer playing by the Beatles in episode 1 in the background due to copyright reasons, but it does have Nobody Knows the Trouble I've Seen by the Seekers. I'll dive into this animation more at a later date in a future review, but I was really impressed with this recreation. I have nitpicks, but for a 7-part story with a pretty big cast and large complex sets and action sequences, the team did a great job. The extended time period of 18 months to put this together really paid off, and I hope future releases get this amount of time in the future. Now, on all 3 discs, you can also view the original surviving episode 2 of The Evil of the Daleks. While there had been talk of a restoration and the cleaning up of this release, you'd be hard-pressed to find any improvements after its DVD release from the mid-2000s. This just looks identical to me. The same goes for the last Dalek special feature on Disc 3, which was part of the Lost in Time collection, and also finds its way here basically unaltered from its DVD release. I can understand just copying and pasting the Lost in Time feature, even though that was shot on film and could have been restored and improved, but the actual episode 2, the actual surviving story, I don't know, I just can't see any sort of improvement or cleanup from 2004. But anyway, on Disc 3, we've got The Dalek Factor, a half-hour making-of documentary which sees some of the cast and crew return to the story's main location, Grimm's Dyke Hotel. Narrated by Mark Reynolds, it's a decent documentary, but with so little surviving footage to talk about, and so few people to talk about the story with who were involved in its creation, you can tell that the edit for this was an uphill struggle. Still, Fraser Hines is always fun, it was great to see the Dalek props in the hotel again, and obviously, I really appreciate the effort that has gone into this feature. I'd be complaining if there wasn't a behind-the-scenes feature, so I'm glad that this is here, I really am. But when it comes to the actual specifics and the making of for this story, you'll find a lot of that info in the booklet included in this Blu-ray set, which is incredibly comprehensive and informative. That is where you'll find most of the actual making of for this serial. Also included in this set on Disc 2 is an interview with Chris Thompson, a production designer of Doctor Who, talking us through his career and time on Evil of the Daleks in this 15-minute interview recorded in 2018. We've got a HD photo gallery with Toby Haddock and Story's second unit director Timothy Coombe narrating over it, and also an animation gallery, though there's no making of feature for the animation process, which feels a bit strange by its absence. However, what is incredibly thorough and comprehensive are the audio delights in this set. Firstly, included in this set is the 1992 audiobook retelling of Evil of the Daleks, originally released on cassette by the BBC Audio Collection produced by John Nathan Turner, and narrated by 4th Doctor Tom Baker. Now, is this the best way to experience the Evil of the Daleks? Absolutely not, but I love that it's here.
As light started to fill the control room, their eyes travelled upwards. There before them, was the vast Emperor Dalek.
And lastly, Toby Haddock has recorded and put together an incredible collection of audio commentaries for this release, one of the most comprehensive lists that I've seen. We have Episode 2 with a 2004 interview with Victoria actor Deborah Watling. Episode 2 again with Chris Thompson in conversation with Phil Newman from 2018. Episode 4 with assistant floor manager David Tilley from 2021 and Kemal actor Sonny Caldenez recorded in 2002. Episode 5, an unreleased archive interview from 1985 with the episode's director, Derek Martinez, which is such a fascinating listen and was my favourite of the set.
Pat Trout, I mean, what's it like working with Pat?
Pat is such an intelligent chap, and he is such a fine actor and so amusing, and he brought such a humour to it. He's such a nice person and such a good actor and so adaptable.
He suggested that he comes as well from Spain.
Yes.
And he and Fraser Hines and Deborah Watling got on very well.
They did, yeah. Mm.
So you've got a great rapport there. Pat Troutman and Fraser Hines are back doing another Doctor Who.
You're joking!
No, they're doing a thing called The Two Doctors with the current Doctor and his female companion.
Oh, really?
Yes, written by Robert Holmes.
Oh,
it's a real reunion.
Good Lord.
They're recording at the moment at Television Centre.
With Fraser?
Yeah. Fraser's up there in his kilt still.
And lastly, episode 7 with both Fraser Hines and also Timothy Coombe, who directed the final end studio and model shots for the episode. And lastly, my favourite bonus feature, which could have so easily have been forgotten, but firstly some context. The Evil of the Daleks received a repeat broadcast in 1968 to bridge the gap between Season 5 and Season 6, where the ending of The Wheel in Space has the Second Doctor telling new companion Zoe of the terrors that she's about to face. Now, this set includes the narrated intro recorded for this repeat by Patrick Troughton for Episode 1. I'm so happy that this is here, and I can't quite explain why.
Now, as I remember, Zoe, it all started when Jamie and I discovered somebody making off with the TARDIS.
And also, full transparency, this set also includes ROM PDF documents with camera scripts and radio times listings. However, due to my setup at home, I have no way to access these. Overall though, with the exception of a missing animated making of feature and some nitpicks with the 4x3 version of the story, I have very little to complain about. This is an incredibly comprehensive release, especially on the audio side. It's clear that all of the attention went to the colour animated recreation, which is also evident in how the surviving episode 2 seems to have received no restoration or touch-ups since its initial 2004 DVD release, but this 3-hour epic story is now viewable for the first time in 53 years, with loads of material to dive into in this Blu-ray and DVD release. So overall though, this is a pretty big deal in terms of Doctor Who releases. Evil of the Daleks is an incredibly well-regarded story. Patrick Troughton actually called it one of his favourite stories. As for me, I wasn't a big fan of Evil of the Daleks. I did review it back in 2019 for Dalek-cember. I did find it to be a bit overrated, but maybe this animated version is going to make me reevaluate it. Maybe it will give the story a new lease on life, and maybe it will let me see what everybody else appears to see in The Evil of the Daleks. As for my Second Doctor animated collection, yeah, this doesn't really line up properly. Maybe it's actually not too bad. Maybe it kind of does. It mainly sticks out because you don't have the cardboard sleeve and the blue top there, the blue spine there. But yeah, we've got Power of the Daleks. We've got the Macrotera, which in my opinion is the gold standard for Doctor Who animations. We have got the Faceless Ones, which I still haven't watched yet. I still need to do that. We've got the Web of Fear as well, which I reviewed on the channel. At time of recording this video, though, it is still under copyright content ID deadlock. So if you want to get early access to this review, please consider supporting me on Patreon. And we also have Fury from the Deep as well. I still haven't finished watching this either. But yeah, we've got Evil of the Daleks as well, which will slot in between the Web of Fear and the Faceless Ones, because the Evil of the Daleks opens exactly where the Faceless Ones left off. So there we go. That's the collection so far. So the next release is Galaxy 4, which is a William Hartnell animated story, which I'm really looking forward to. There's a BFI screening next month. month, so be sure to subscribe to the Mr. TARDIS YouTube channel so you can find out exactly what's going to be happening with Galaxy 4 when I unbox and review that. Thank you so much for watching me unbox the Evil of the Dalek Steelbook, and I'll see you all next time.